and these men may go home unscathed, and they may return to their wife and their children. But who here thinks that that might be done? Bring your things in mind. He didn't come here to die. Tobias is not so sure. He's seen a lot of this sort of thing. Many years of experience of carrying the king's word at the point of his sword.
I'll raise your one champion, two champions.
And so they arrange between them a championship fight. That a little blood be shed instead of a lot.
That's three men who can serve as champions for you.
But they rarely decide anything. Usually, they serve to tee off the opposition. Make them play. From the Lord's Mead Hall, and the knowledge that he will be remembered when it's time to fight again. No, there is no water for the Vikings. Tobias is impassive. It's a sign that he's taken off his green cloak. He means business now. Saxon England, after all, and though the Danes settled all the way down through the Danelaw, they settled amongst the Saxon people. Very reasonable. If things went badly, it would be the Saxons that turned on the Danes. So Bryce's Day massacre is not that far in the past. And both sides go forward together. Eastern Viking and his orange line coat, unusually dressed for these parts, must be a personal friend of Brynjolf. But they press forward, the Saxons press hard, and the Vikings are losing. Brynjolf was right to be nervous, but the field is scattered with people. Is it possible that even now they can be pulled back together? But Brynjolf is hard set and is down. Brand is still on his feet and tries to rally the troops. What Saxons are there left? Can it be yet done? Alfgar is on his feet. But whichever side wins, it's going to be a Pyrrhic victory. You find an old axe and sharpen it? Would you cram something on your head, something made of leather which you ran up last night so you could go and fight the Vikings or the Saxons? What would you do? What would you do when The cry came, Stepan! 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 Ladies and gentlemen, the warriors of Regia and Glora. And here we go. Bring the old around the back of the Saxons. He's doing better than he did last time. Tobias is at it. Sibbert, the Manx Viking, getting cut off. He looks around him, calls for support. Can he find any? He runs away to help others. Gets there just in time to be speared himself. Oh, can he win? The lines are split. This is no way to win for anybody. Is it going to be a draw? Or is it going to be a home win for the Vikings? Alfgar's still on his feet. That beat the Saxons already. But my God, there's not many of them. At this rate, they're going to have to fight each other to get out of the Danelaw. There's four of them on their feet. Not very convincing, though. Awful lot of dead people out there. Dead arrived.